Alright, I'm really, really, really sorry about this, but this episode's going to be a bit of a... Well, there's stuff playing in my mind, things we've got to fix, some things that we've worked on recently that we've got to fix, and some things that we've worked on in the past that we've got to fix, like far in the past. One of these things, or most of these things, lie in this area. I did hint that we would need to fix the maze and the parkour area. That's what we're here for. I don't know how successful this is going to be, but we shall see. So I guess first of all, let's make ourselves a way in. Cool, right. So the idea with this is that we need to figure out... Well, basically, there was when we did the maze back in episode 115, there was a section that got completely cut off, and I'm trying to remember what doors they were. I think, don't quote me on this, but I think it was this door, and this door over here. It was these three. One was, like, they were all shut, and I was completely cut off from the rest of the maze. So what we need to do is maybe try to figure out how we can link two of these together. Oh, it's going to be so difficult. I don't know how we could do it. Yeah, how are we going to link two of them together and then reroute one of the other doors? It's just a complete mess, isn't it? There's no redstone there for some reason. anyone's guess as to why that is the case? I think I changed the design of something, but I just don't remember what I changed it to or where it's going. Alternatively, we could cheap out and increase the rate at which these doors open and close. That's a possibility. So this one here and that one over there I think are important ones. This one I don't really care about. That door's open, but I don't know where it goes right enough. I think it just goes somewhere. Wait. Okay. So, I've just realised something incredibly stupid. Something that I've never known before. Let's just go straight to... dead end, I think. Oh no, this... No, no, this doesn't go to dead end. Where does it go though? Oh, it goes to the other side of this door. Right, well that's good. Okay, I think we'll cheap out, but we'll cheap out under the assumption that if we link any of that one, and that one together, it's going to be too easy. So, what we're going to do is we're going to increase the rate at which some of these doors open. Open and close, that is. What we need to do... Which ones should we do? I don't want to do that one, because that one's too easy, because that's the first door you come across at the start. So we'll do this one. We'll increase the rate at which this one opens and closes. And the way we do that is by following this wire here through this mess. Don't actually know what this is. I've forgotten what that is. Is that an XOR gate? I think that's an old XOR gate. And yeah, here we go. So what we're going to do is we're going to hop down here. And we're just going to simply... Yeah. Add wire all the way around. And that way... Oh, we need to add that there. Well, that way it basically means that every time this cactus is harvested, it will always activate the door. So it goes from a really good chance, a really high chance that the doors will activate and change states to a 100% guarantee that the doors will activate and change. Then again, that might not be a good thing. It might involve the player getting trapped. So yeah, from that point of view, you're probably wanting to increase the rate at which another door switches state. Probably this one here. And we can follow that if we go back through this XOR gate, and that will take us all the way over here. So yeah, this has got a pretty high chance, more than a 50% chance of activation. There we go. Now that's going to affect the other doors as well, but I don't think it makes much of a difference. The thing is, in practice, this is a good idea. But, no, sorry, in theory, it's a good idea. In practice, it's... There's a few issues. I think the maze, for starters, like, the maze wasn't designed necessarily to be a maze. I copied this off of from an image. And I think in the description it said it was randomly generated, so it's not as if this was, you know, prefabricated with, you know, design and difficulty in mind and all that. Hey, right. Now we're going to sort out this mess of this mess of a challenge. So yeah, the only reason I built this as part of the parkour challenge was because I wasted iron on rails. I think I cut that from the episode as well. So yeah, all these things that I've done off camera that I'm having to fix on camera, bit embarrassing, but there you go. So what we're going to do is we're going to pick up all of this stuff. Oh, what's that? What is that? Oh, that goes to the door. Yeah, that goes to the door. I forgot about that. The door for the other side. There we go. We'll just pick up this. And we're out of inventory space. How wonderful. We'll just eat some food. Get rid of the food. Who needs food? And that leaves us with a bit of a pit here. With which I've got no idea what to do. Then again, maybe we don't need to do anything that's super serious. Maybe just something quirky. From what I remember, the rest of the course is okay. None of it is broken, really. You can do it all, which is good. The only thing I would think about changing would be the one where you've got to climb up that pillar and you get shot from two sides. I mean, that's kind of difficult, but the point is it works. This didn't work, and it was kind of silly. It was the only one you could actually legitimately cheat without doing it, which is why I didn't rate it. Like, you could just jump down and right-click the block, or the boat, rather, and get out. So, I mean, in analysing this, what have we got? We've got a four-block gap, which can't be bridged. I mean, we could just put a block in the middle, but that's kind of boring. We could put a block in the middle with a door going. That would be interesting, to say the least. So, yeah, what we could do... Hear me out with this one. Oh, we don't have any iron. Oh, rats, we didn't bring any iron. I just tried to cook some food there, and I realised I needed fuel, didn't have any. Tried to cook with lava, it works, but unfortunately it takes the entire bucket, which is not surprising in the slightest, but there you go. I think I'm just going to make good use of this fuel, because I don't know how long it's going to last. I'm going to smelt up some stone, because why not? There we go. Right, anyway, so the plan I've got is quite basic. Oh, flip, I need to craft. We're going to make four doors of the iron variety, and then we're going to have them all in a line across the middle of this parkour area. We might have more, actually. Maybe three. I don't know. Let's make them here. Let's put them here, right? And then we'll put them up this high. So let's just get that on. And then they're all going to be facing different ways, I reckon. Oh, not that way though. Okay, so currently they're all like that. That should be fine. If we go down, we're going to have them be powered by redstone torches, I would think. This is going to come right above redstone, isn't it? Oh no, it actually looks like it might work out, which is nice. It's nice that it works out for once. Right, let's get the ladders that we've got remaining. Use them to get back up. I think we're just going to, yeah, do that. Now, I want some of these to be inverted. So I want the doors to open alternately, basically. That's the idea. And it's not going to be challenging, it's just for the wow factor, really. And it's two blocks wide, so the player can make the jump. And we'll add some more torches here. And then below two of them, we'll add another torch. In fact, We'll make them all go down one more. And then we'll make only two of them go down one more after that. And then the redstone action can occur this side, I reckon. I need some torches. I don't have all that many torches, unfortunately. Coal is in short supply. I hate to say it, but I'm going to have to go caving at some point. On camera. It has to be on camera. I need to do everything on camera. Nah, I'm kidding. I don't know. If I can think of something fun to do while caving, I could do it on camera, but usually they just result in me talking about random gibberish. Or not talking about random gibberish, but talking random gibberish. Right. Let's do that. Put that stuff there. This might work, actually. This may work better than anticipated. So if we do that... Oh, please work. Do we have any... We don't have any... I've just realised we don't have any... repeaters. That should be the doors working. I can feel the lag, man. It's incredible. Redstone is not very well optimised. Yep, it's working. All of them are working. So let's go to the ladder. And have a think about how this is going to work practically. Let's tone the sounds down. I've already got a ladder up there. Would help if I could actually climb it. That's not too bad. I don't even mind that it's slightly off. I think it's always going to be slightly off. Just because of the nature of torches in these updates. But yeah, it's going to be as simple as doing that. But then what we could have... is an extra challenge here, where if we hop down here, the player's got to make the jump with a roof or something. Don't know how you would do that. Is that even possible? I think it is, but I just don't know how to do it. Oh, that was a mistake. We've got to be careful here because I don't have all that much in the way of food. Hey, there we go. Okay, so it is possible. You just need to time it right. There's one lonely squid in the long lake. Oh, you're going to be able to see the mountain for here, aren't you? Let's take a closer look, shall we? At the monstrosity that's taking shape. Ah, there it is. You can see it very, very well from here. Just a big box. We're going to have to cover that over. That's going to be a monumental task to make that look natural. So yeah, if you haven't guessed it, we're going to be working on the arena. Once again, the zombie arena. I've got one last attempt, or one last plan, to make this work. I'm not expecting it to work, but, you know, it's one last plan. So, what we're going to do is we need to act quickly. Oh, I should... Oh, darn it. Oh, that was such a waste. I should have used... I was going to use the plank, and instead I used... I've put the coal in without thinking. Right, we've got to be quick here. We're going to take the cobble and we're going to block off the far end. Let's go, let's go, let's go. We're going to block off the far end. You know, prevent zombies from coming up. Maybe right there. Why is there a diagonal water stream? Why is there not just one pushing them straight ahead? I wonder if that was getting them stuck or something. I think one thing we need to do is that, yeah, we need to... Oh, hi. Yeah, we can't even be doing that. Right, what we're going to do is we're going to take off some of this. And what I want to do is I want to cover the spawner area in obsidian. So that includes... we need to get rid of that, I'm afraid. That includes basically all of this. And that way we know exactly what is and what isn't... you know, something that we not to touch. For example, that's something not to touch. So I'm going to turn that into obsidian. Oh no, I took out a side! Oh shoot, I took out a side. Right, so all blocks that we're not allowed to dig are covered in obsidian. I'm happy with that. Actually, we're not to dig that one. So we'll take that out. Now what I want to do is I want to go back to having the two-door system, but I also want to have a water stream forcing the zombies out the door, basically. Now this is going to get annoying very quickly. So the problem is there's going to be no space whatsoever. So if we do that, and then if we do that, get this door on, and then there's water pushing the zombies out. But then what we're going to have to do is we're going to have to remove that to give them space, basically. Because if that's... Oh yeah, we'll have to get rid of that too. Because if those are away, then the zombies have got a clear way out. Now the only... The biggest problem is we now need to figure out a way of wiring the doors. I think I've got an answer. What we're going to do is we're just going to hop down here. We're going to have to dig away quite a bit. At least the spawner's still working. I'm still really gutted about how the mob spawning seems to have changed. So that's powered. And then we need to power that. So they're powered in the wrong way. Which means we're going to have to change it so that one of them is inverted. I guess we'll invert this one because there's more space here. Okay, so I think I've got it working. As you can see, both the doors are shut. If we go over here, both the doors will open once I flick this lever. And hopefully the water that you can see there will act as a means of forcing the zombies into this corner here. So, this is the wiring. It's very simple. I completely blocked off that area because we don't need it. We've got the torch there that powers one door. There is going to be a slight delay on this door up here, but I'm not that fussed, honestly. It doesn't need to be exact. I won't even see it. Right, so now, just to be in keeping with everything we've done so far, I'm going to add some blocks around about here. We're just going to dump down the last of the torches. Just to get rid of them, to be honest. Not for any other reason. We're down to 3 pieces of obsidian, that's fine. Be nice if there was a smooth access route, but that doesn't exist. Now what we're going to do is try to break that block above there. There we go, we got it. Cool. So now we're going to be able to get all the zombies to come up here, hopefully. I'm worried they're going to get jammed in there. But I feel like the fact there was a piece of the water going there sort of prevented them from properly falling. The reason I got rid of those blocks there was because I wanted to give them an even better chance of getting out. They all seem to be falling in there, so I'm not too worried. I'm just worried that I'm going to get stuck up from behind by a creeper or something. Are you ready? Oh, there's something in there. Hopefully they don't find a way in. Okay. Now we've got to be careful here. We don't want to fight because... Actually, you know what, let's turn the sounds up a wee bit. I want to see if there's guys still stuck there. There are still guys stuck there. Right, we need the sun to come. My sword's about to break. Oh, here we go. Yeah, unfortunately there's still guys stuck in there. The water hasn't quite worked to perfection. I mean, I think we've improved it. We've definitely improved it, but we've not solved the main problem, which was too many zombies getting stuck in there. The problem is it's because of the blocks, I think. You know, the blocks, the doors, they see them as full blocks. That's the sort of... Right, whoa, let's get out. Sorry, I just went in because I saw there was a sign there. Don't want to give up on a sign because they're not cheap. Right, we can't die because I've broken my bed and I've got a lot of stuff on me. So, we'll call it a wrap for today. Maybe we can improve it in future. Oh, it's a dog! And I don't have a single bone in me. So there's only one thing left to do. Oh, he's mad. He's mad. Oh, no, no, he might actually kill me. Oh, he took out a sheep as well. Oh, hello, zombie. Fight the wolf for me, please. Okay, never mind. And I'm sure you could have guessed it, but yeah, we're back here. Back here again, as the meme goes. So, what I'm going to do is we're going to alter this ever so slightly. We're not going to do anything with the actual spawning areas. Actually, is there anything in there? Ooh. Is that? That must be a mob. There's no way that's a... I really want to jump in and just see if that's a mob or a squid. That name there. But it's jumping around, so it must be a mob. Yeah, what we're going to do is we're going to actually just hop down. And we're going to basically get rid of all this. And the lowest spawning area that the squid can spawn at is Y45. So we're going to go up to 24 blocks below that, which is, if I can do the maths properly, 45 minus 24 is 21. So that's where we're going up to. And we might as well fill up with this. Alright, we're up at Y21 here. Those are all mobs. Like, those two would be moving a bit more rapidly if they were squid, I'm pretty sure. Anyway, what we're going to do here is I kind of want to add a bit of a killing system. And by killing system, I just mean putting up some lava for the squid to fall into. So we'll do that here. We just need to make three more sides. Like so. And then we've got four buckets of lava. So we can just pop them on top. And that not only kills them, or it should not only kill them, but it will also light the area up, which is nice. That's assuming they spawn, of course. And then... yeah, then we need to dig this way in order to get back to the ladder. And we're going to have to fill in the tunnel below, because this is the... I think the minimum distance? This is the minimum distance, the optimal distance that we can be away from the... you know, the place where the squid spawn. If I've been calling them slime, I'm sorry, but they're squid. I know they're squid. Yeah, I'm not convinced by this. It may be that this version, slime don't spawn in... or not slime, squid, sorry. It may be that squid don't spawn in downward flowing water. The one good thing is we don't have to travel as far to get back to the surface. I could make a water ladder, but I don't think it's worth it on the basis that they are probably on their way out. What was he doing? Just running into the fence. Oh, dearie me. Okay, well, this was, of all the changes we've made, this is probably the one that's going to be least effective. Again, I always want to, like, take this into a future version just to see if it works. Like, take this into 1. Well, maybe one of the modern 1.13 or something. Because it sure as heck ain't working in this version. Anyway, we'll figure it out nearer the time. Nearer the time when we need it most, which will probably be too late. Probably be at the end of the series. Anyway, I'm going to end the episode there. Apologies, it's just been fixing stuff, but that's kind of important. It's got to be done. But next episode, we'll be back to building something, hopefully. Until then, bye for now.